Shall we take the national anthem?
We'll be more steady.
Prayer.
Shall we pray, please? Our Father, in the name of Jesus, we are very grateful unto you for your love. We thank you very much again for this day that you have made for your son, glory in. Thank you for your son, the lecturer, very special lecturer this day. Thank you for all his years of work, and thank you for this little attempt to show off how much you have helped him. We ask that in all things you take preeminence in the name of Jesus. Thank you for journey mercies for all our guests. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because you will superintend over this program, and at the end we will again celebrate you and glorify you in Jesus' name. Thank you for doing beyond our asking, for in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Thank you very much. Please be seated.
I'd like to welcome you to this inaugural lecture, the 7th edition. Permit me to establish the protocol. The Vice Chancellor, Professor Anthony Enison Aquino, the Deputy Vice Chancellor, Professor Mrs. Adebola Adebileje, welcome. The Bursar of our University, Mrs. Mofolusha Olutayo David, unavoidably absent this afternoon. And the Acting University Librarian, Dr. Akiniyi Adeleke, you're welcome. We'd like to welcome specially into our midst the second Vice Chancellor of our University and his wife, Professor Z. Debo Adeyewa. You're welcome, Starma. Permit me to welcome the second registrar of our university, Mrs. Bola Titoloketui. You're welcome. The Provost College of Postgraduate Studies, Professor Ahmed Yerima. You're welcome, sir. Deans of faculty, beginning from Faculty of Basic Medical Sciences, Professor B.A. Salau. You're welcome, sir. Faculty of Humanities, Professor A. O. Dairo, you are welcome, sir. Faculty of Law, Professor O. Yerokun, you are welcome, sir. Faculty of Management Sciences, Professor Mrs. B. Adeleke, you are welcome, sir. The Dean of the inaugural lecturer of today, Professor Adeleke Osho, you are welcome, sir. I also want to welcome the Dean, Faculty of Social Sciences, Professor I. B. Oloyede, you are welcome. All our royal fathers in the house, you welcome. The chairman inaugural inaugural committee, Professor Laleri Adeyemi, you're welcome. Permit me to welcome the director, academic planning and quality assurance, Professor E. I. Unabona. Director of educational services and training, Professor U. E. Vincent, you're welcome. Directorate of Research, Innovation and Partnership, DRIPS, and also the Director of African Center of Excellence for Genomics and of Infectious Diseases, ASGID, Professor Christian Appy, you are welcome. The Director, Center of Entrepreneurial Development Studies, Professor A. Adeleke, you are welcome. Director of General Studies, Professor I. Odebode, you are welcome. The Director of Adeboye Institute of Peace and Good Governance, Professor O. Ekunade, you are welcome. Permit me to welcome all Senate members and our immediate past Provost of College of Postgraduate Studies, Professor G. A. Kolawole, you are welcome. Then Professor I. Okomolafe, you are most welcome. So with this, other announcements will be done later. I want to welcome the Vice Chancellor as he gives his address. The Vice Chancellor.
Let me remind us that the first inaugural lecture was held in June 2013, the second on 12 May 2015, the third on 14th February 2017, the fourth on 12th April 2018, the fifth on 30th August 2018, while the sixth was held on 3rd December 2020. The inaugural lecture today is for Kayode Samuel Adekeye, a professor of statistics in the Faculty of Natural Sciences. We'll be speaking on the topic assignable variation, the unknown that must be known. Professor Kayode Samuel Adekeye was born to lead by Ezekiel Olabi Adekeye and Deaconess Deborah Adekeye of Ishanu Isin in Isin local government area of Kola State on 20th February 1966. And 2001, respectively. He had his PhD in statistics from the University of Dortmund, Germany, in 2004. He started his academic career as assistant lecturer at the Kuala State Polytechnics in Lorry in 1991 before joining the services of Redeemer's University as a senior lecturer in 2007. He was promoted to full professor of statistics in 2013 and adds to his compendium of academic degrees a series of professional certifications in statistics and in quality assurance. Professor Adekeye, as a seasoned statistician of high academic standing, has carried out a commendable amount of high-quality research and statistical quality control, evident in over 40 publications in both national and international peer-reviewed scientific journals. His research areas are statistical quality control, statistical process control, process capability analysis, design of screening experiment with particular emphasis on analysis of replicated experiments, exploratory data analysis, and social quality management. As a teacher, Professor Adekeye has taught several statistics courses across all levels within and outside the university system. He has supervised many students at the OND, HND, BSc, MSc, and PhD levels. Recently, he formed a modeling and analytic research group in the Department of Mathematical Sciences of Redeemer's University to establish a problem-solving research base and foster mentorship. He has served as external examiner to several Nigerian and foreign universities. Furthermore, Kayode serves as a reviewer to several journals across the group. He is a chartered statistician and a fellow of the Royal Statistical Society in London, fellow of the Nigeria's Statistical Association. He is also a member of some professional bodies such as American Statistical Association, Nigerian Institute of Industrial Statistics, and Professional Statistical Association of Nigeria. Professor Adekeye served as the pioneer deputy vice chancellor of this great university from 20th January 2015 to 27th January 2019. Member, University Governing Council 2015 to 2019. Pioneer director, Academic Planning and Quality Assurance 2013 to 2018. And acting head, Department of Mathematical Sciences from 2010 to 2011. In the last 13 years at Redeemer's University, he has chaired many strategic committees with laudable achievements, some of which are Chairman, University Research Grants and Staff Development Committee 2015 to 2019, Chairman, Bulk Purchase Committee for 7 years, 2011 to 2018, and Chairman, Sports Council 2015 to 2019. K, as he is fondly called by his friends and followers, is a recipient of many awards within and outside the Redeemer universities. Some selected ones among them West African Agri-Food Quality Assurance Network 2016 to date. Award of Excellence from Redeemer's University Students Association 2016. Long Service Award from Redeemer's University 2017. Icon of of Humanitarian Award from West African Students Union 2017, Special Recognition Award from ROSA 2017 and 2018, Meritorious Service Award from the Dimas University 2018, Gakuwan Matasan Arewa Award by the Northern Youth Council of Nigeria 2018, Award of Honor from Nigeria Association of Clinical Psychologists 2018, Third Consultant and Expert in the Field of Quality Assurance Management in Higher Education Institutions 2019 to date, Project Coordinator 2019 to 2020, and a Hero of Southwest Nigerian by Southwest Nigerian Excellence Award 2020. Professor Adekeye is very thorough, focused, result-oriented, purposeful, with good analytical, negotiating, interpersonal, and advocacy skills. He enjoys playing volleyball and watching football, singing, making, seeing movies, and involves himself in intellectual discussions. He is happily married to Mrs. Yabode Modupe Adekeye, and the marriage is blessed with two wonderful children. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to invite you all to listen with rapt attention as our eminent and erudite for Kayode Samuel Adekeye speaks on the topic Assignable Variation, the Unknown That Must Be Known. God bless you, Professor Adekeye.
Of postgraduate studies, deans of faculties, directors of directorates and centers and units, vice chancellors and principal officers from sister universities, rectors, provosts, deans and staff from other institutions, your royal highnesses and chiefs, distinguished the title of this lecture came up. I've been playing with different titles for the lectures. Was to become a pharmacist, but I'm a statistician and What you have in red is labeled as high risk, and the sky blue are the low risk states. As a statistician and researcher, we do not leave the statement at that point. That is to say that we have by the presence of trend. And so in this work, we introduce another structure, which we call systematic order, which will not be biased with the main effect of interest, and of course also be free of the effect. The data is being used to perturb and using the setting of the tool design that I've just shown. And it is expected that the absolute estimate of the contrast used to perturb the data should be higher than the absolute estimate of all other contrasts in the design matrix, and n should become an outlier to all other contrasts on the half-normal plot. Two data examples were used, and using these two data sets, on the design that we have on table 3, that's the standard run order and the systematic run order, we are able to get a better result. The graph we have on figure 10, figure 11, and figure 12 are the half-normal plot for the data that were generated using the setting. and achieve greater profitability and a strong competitive advantage. SQC has the following activities. It can be used to define a goal, it can be used to measure the goal, it can be used to analyze, improve, and control, and so which is in the acronym DMIC. The DMIC process is an excellent framework used in conducting quality improvement projects, and it is often associated with Six Sigma, but regardless of the approach taken by an organization strategically, it is an excellent critical tool for quality professionals to employ. According to Adekeye 2013, SQC is a statistical method that contains analytical tools used to evaluate the five M's. Evaluation obtained by the SQC methods assists in maintaining desired results by using historical data to predict capabilities or trends. The analytical methods are management tools that furnish data to all levels of supervision for appropriate action. SQC differs from the procedure of manufacturing a product according to schedule and then sorting the product into acceptable and not acceptable lots. Eventually, these control methods help to decide two things. One, when the process is operating at a satisfactory level, and when the process level is not satisfactory, and corrective action is required to prevent the manufacture of unacceptable products. SQC comprises a set of statistical tools used by quality control professionals. It can be divided into three broad bands: descriptive statistics, statistical process control, and acceptance sampling. Out of these three tools, the tool in each of these categories provides type of information for use in quality analysis. Although descriptions of specific characteristics are helpful, they are not enough to identify whether there is a problem with quality. Acceptance sampling can help in deciding on the acceptability after the product has been produced. It does not aid in identifying a quality problem during the production process. It is the SPC tools that can help in identifying quality problem during production, which is our focus, the identification of quality problem. And thus, we'll be talking on one of the tools, which is the control chart. The control chart is the major SPC tool used primarily for monitoring process for improvement purposes. Data, either discrete or continuous, which are generated over some time, can be using an appropriate control chart. The control chart, by my definition and experience over the last 2 days, is a utility tool that can be utilized by product engineers to record and analyze tests, by accountants to analyze cost, by process engineers to determine machine and process capabilities, by production engineers to monitor operations, by inspections and quality controllers to report scraps and rework, and to analyze incoming materials quality, and by higher education institution management to improve the quality of deliverables and services. Thus, control charts can be considered as one of the most versatile tools in statistical methods. The operation of a control chart is based on observing sample statistics value plotted on a control chart, which are considered to be in control if all the plotted statistics values fall within the control limit and show no signs of settled trends, runs, or definite pattern. Likewise, the operation under investigation is considered to be subject to the assignable cause of variation when the chart shows an out-of-control condition. A conceptual control chart is presented. In conclusion, data is the bedrock on which statistics rest.
like to invite the Vice Chancellor to present to him the medallion while we have a seat. Thank you. Permit me to take a few announcements before the close of this event. I'd like to welcome into our midst Akabiesi all the way from Isolu Isi. Is she okay? His Royal Majesty Oba Dr. Solomon Olubigalede, you're welcome, sir. Akabiesi, you're welcome. I want to welcome and recognize the presence of Professor Bolanle Akinwande from Lautech. You are welcome. Dr. J. Adewara, Deputy Director, Unilag. You are welcome. Professor J. Olaleru from Unilag. You are welcome. I want to specially welcome the wife of the inaugural lecturer, Mrs. Yabo Adekeye. You are welcome. Permit me to welcome Mrs. Abiodun Olabisi Akindele, Permanent Secretary of the State Civil Service. You're welcome. I also want to welcome Professor J. Bamiduro, former Dean, Natural Sciences. You're welcome, sir. We have in our midst our gold scholars. The university has decided to showcase these young ones. I want them to just rise up for recognition. They are all the best performing students in their various faculties. God bless you. God will continue to increase you. Thank you. You can have your seats. God bless you. All of them are in first class, and they are doing very well, and the university has decided to offer them scholarship. So, for all our guests here today, we want to use us to inform you that Redeemer's University is the best place for you. Send your children, send your word. Our admission exercise is still in progress. And let me inform us that we have 8 faculties and the College of Postgraduate Studies. They are Basic Medical Sciences, Engineering, Environmental Sciences, Humanities. We have law, we have management sciences, we have natural sciences, and faculty of social sciences. In addition to this, we have the foundation program being packaged together under desks. So, send your children to Redeemer's University for the best of academic training as well as spiritual impartation. God bless you as you do so in Jesus' name. The inaugural lecturer has asked me to inform you that all staff can go to Manor Palace for their refreshment. Other guests of the inaugural lecturer should go to his residence at their own staff quarters. The Lord will continue to bless everyone in Jesus' name. Without wasting your time, I will invite the Vice Chancellor to give us the closing remark. Then thereafter, the chaplain to give us the closing prayer. The Vice Chancellor, sir.
I just want to say that I hereby declare this inaugural lecture closed. God bless you.
please, shall we?
Shall we all rise, please? Let us pray. Our Father, in the name of Jesus, we want to thank you for this glorious day that you have given to us. We want to particularly thank you on behalf of your Son, the inaugural lecturer, for your help and support over his life from the beginning up to this moment. Please take all the glory in the name of Jesus. Thank you for standing by him through the thick and the thin. Thank you for holding him by the hand to this high level. Father, take all the glory in Jesus' name. Thank you for his family. Thank you for his educational pursuit. Thank you for today as an icing on the cake of his pursuit. Please take all the glory, O God, in Jesus' name. We hand him over to you that he will continue to go from glory to glory in Jesus' name. That he will preserve his life and guide him good and sound mind to fulfill all your counsel concerning him in the name of Jesus. We pray for all our friends and well-wishers who have come from far and near as you return back to your various homes. The Lord God of heaven will take you back safely in Jesus' name. No evil will befall anyone in the name of Jesus. We pray for this university that will continue to grow in leaps and bounds in the name of Jesus, for the knowledge, for all wisdom to do exploits in the name of Jesus. And we pray that for all of us who desire great and glorious events in life like this, that you will make it happen for us in Jesus' name. Thank you, Eternal Father. Glory be to your name. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Photographs after this, we will do so in front of the Vice Chancellor's office. We want to take the university anthem and the national anthem. Please, let's remain standing. We take the procession now in reverse order while you remain standing. Thank you.
Savior.